Got another word problem for you.
That's way too many words. So you know what we're going to do here? We're going to turn all these words into some math. Let's see here. We got Tony has a favorite fraction. I mean, who doesn't? What's your favorite fraction? I'm not telling you mine. No, no, no. We're going to find Tony's here instead. He adds 1 to the numerator, subtracts 1 from the denominator. He gets something that equals 2/3. If instead he subtracts 3 from the numerator, adds 3 to the denominator, he gets something that equals 2/5. What's his favorite fraction? I can't guess it from this. Now, you know what? Let's write some equations. Let's turn all these words into some math, write some equations, and that'll be a lot easier than just thinking about all this stuff up here. We'll start off with some variables. And as usual, we use obvious variables. N is the numerator. D is the denominator. All right. Adds 1 to the numerator, subtracts 1 from the denominator, gets something that equals 2/3. And down here, instead, he subtracts 3 from the numerator, adds 3 to the denominator, he gets something that's equal to 2/5. Yikes. I don't like this variables in the denominator stuff. That's no good. So what I'm going to do here first is I'm going to get rid of these fractions. These fractions make me a little nervous. What I'll do is I'll multiply this first equation. I'm going to multiply both sides by 3 and by d minus 1. That'll cancel the d minus 1 over here. That'll cancel the 3 over there. And we'll get 3 times n plus 1 equals 2 times d minus 1. All right, that's better. Down here, we're going to do same thing. We're going to take both sides, multiply them both by 5. That'll get rid of this. Multiply both sides by d plus 3. That'll knock out the d plus 3 over here. Now I'm going to put this up here. We'll get 5 times n minus 3 equals 2 times d plus 3. All right, so now we'll expand both sides of this equation, and we'll have 3n plus 3 equals 2d minus 2. And down here, 5n minus 15 equals 2d plus 6. And just like that, we've taken these two equations here. This is a system of equations, but they're not linear. But once we clear out the denominators here, multiply both sides by the denominator, suddenly we've turned this system that doesn't look like a system of linear equations into a system of linear equations, and we know how to handle this. I mean, right here, I'm looking at this, I'm seeing we can set up the elimination basically right now. But instead, first, get organized. Always stay organized. I'm going to bring all the variables over here, all the constants over there. But if you wanted to try this at home, try subtracting the second equation from the first equation right now. You can see that these d's eliminate. You can eliminate the d's right there. See if you can do that on your own. But I'm going to stay organized here. I'm going to bring the 2d over. I'm going to go minus 2d plus 3n. I'm going to subtract the 3 over there. This is negative 5. Do the same thing here. We get minus 2d plus 5n. Add 15 to both sides. We'll get 21. Now here I can multiply either of these equations by negative 1 to set up my elimination. Or what I'm going to do here is I'm going to subtract. I'm going to subtract one equation from the other. Put it like this so make it clear that we're doing this. I'm going to subtract. I'm going to go this minus this is equal to this minus this. Now we have to be careful with our signs when we do this. Minus 2d minus a negative 2d, they'll cancel. Minus 2d plus 2d, that's 0. That was the whole point of this. 3n minus the 5n, that gives us minus 2n. Minus 5 minus a 21 gives us negative 26. Divide by negative 2, we get n is 13. Now we have to go back and find d. And let's see which one of these. You know what? I'll use this up here. I can take this 13, put it in up there, and we'll get 14 over d minus 1 is 2/3. 14 over what is 2/3? This has to be 21. 14 over 21 is 2/3. So d has to be 22. Now we can go back and check real quick. adds 1 to the numerator, that gives us 14, subtracts 1 from the denominator, that gives us 21. 14 over 21, that's 2/3, that's what we did right up here. If he instead subtracts 3 from the numerator, now notice that when I'm checking this, I'm not checking this by putting these in the equations. I'm checking this by going back to the original problem. Because if we set up the equations incorrectly, we may solve the equations just fine, but still get the wrong answer. When we're checking, we're going back to the original problem. Subtract 3 from the numerator, you get 10. Adds 3 to the denominator, you'll get 25. 10 over 25, 2/5. So Tony's favorite fraction is 13 over 22, and we are done.